In this release, the Teardrops and Tracedrops dialog has been enhanced and can be made expandable similar to other dialogs. You can now work with all the forms of teardropping, including the new curved teardrop engine, from a singular dialog that is customizable to the user. Here, we will add a few teardrops to selected items per the settings in the dialog for teardrops. Next, let's look at the new curved teardrops engine. Note in the dialog that you can select the process you wish to invoke on the objects. Also, you can tell the system how to look at DRCs, whether as pads or traces. You can visualize the dialog for different types of teardrop operations. The much tighter control from the curved teardrops is why it is being more commonly used today in high-speed design. You can also enable dynamic teardropping to take place during interactive routing. And to do this, you can view the dialog for manual or dynamic value settings, which can be different. But settings can easily be copied from one mode to another. We can then change the process type and do bulk teardropping operations as needed, like here by active layer selection. Processing teardrops in your design is now more efficient with a combined, customizable dialog, and you will no longer need smart utilities as the new curved teardrops capability is included.